Hello everybody and welcome back to this part 2 tutorial in which we're going to build this water bucket in Shaper 3D. So how do we now create the handle? This is also really quite simple. Here we have a very nice and clean flat surface. That one I will extrude by 15 millimeters up and as a new body. Then I will hide the bucket. Here's my handle. This handle now I would like to split. I will call the split command. Select one plane, select my body and split. Then I will do this one more time. Split body along this time the Z and X axis. Select the back part of the handle, and then the split back handle and the other half I select and delete. Very good. The handle is symmetrical, so I only need to work on 50%. The rest then we add afterwards. Here, onto this face, I would like to add half of a cylinder. The easiest way to do this is first we measure the height, 50 millimeters, so we can extrude something half of 50 millimeters. So we extrude this 7.5 millimeters. There we are. And then these two edges, we fill it. 7.5 millimeters, G1 only. And this basically is actually now half a cylinder. And this is actually very useful for mechanical parts because when we're going to rotate it around the centerpiece here, then this will be perfect. We have here and here two flat surfaces. When I select two parallel surfaces, I can add a midplane right at the center. This plane will be useful because on this plane, we're going to create actually the sketch that will help us to create the socket this handle will go onto. So we'll select this plane. I will go to sketch. Also here again, you see I have my intersection point of my sketch with these edges. Along there, I will draw a line. This line is actually very useful because it helps me to create kind of like a guide. I will select this line, make this a construction line so it doesn't do any 3D modeling, but I have a midpoint there now. This midpoint is very useful because on that midpoint now I can create a circle, and this is not perfectly centered. 30 millimeters, we can define it. Now we need to actually add a little bit of sketches to the bottom and also onto the top. So I will go ahead, create a horizontal line, go down, go over, and then onto the edge and back to the endpoint. And escape, then I can select these two lines. They have to be horizontal. And then these other three lines, they have to be horizontal and vertical. Now you see actually that these two lines are tangent actually to that circle. And we need to add one more. I will do this up here and then there and escape. And here, both of these two lines, horizontal and vertical, that also makes a 90 degree. Perfect. Very good. So what we have now is actually first a set of sketch profiles we can use to cut actually the opening right into it. I will specify this by 3 millimeters. There we are. And I can select all the interior faces. There we are. And push this over 3 millimeters too. Beautiful. Cool. Now, the upper arc, the lower, or half circle, and the lower half circle, and then the flat piece. And I'm going to extrude this again, 3 millimeters. Make sure that this is not being joined, so new body. And the sketches, I will move away into the other folder. And then this, I will select the mid face and switch from 3 to 6 millimeters. Now we have a nice material thickness. Beautiful. Okay, very nice. This is actually a little bit too deep. That's not really going to be a big problem. I can select this, move this up. Just make sure that we don't move it above it. But we can actually sink this in just a little bit there. Perfect. Because then when we select this and the main bucket and join this together with the Boolean command, it's a nice intersection of volumes. Get a good cat model out of this. So this actually looks really, really nice. The last detail maybe before we start rounding edges is this is a very solid and thick handle. How can we remove material? And let's turn actually the profile here into an H. To make sure I'm not connecting a sketch to any other geometry, I'm deselecting everything, hiding everything. I have this face selected, go to sketch, and then I start to draw a line horizontal and down and up and onto the intersection point again. You can also draw really fast. Like you see, I did in my second case, then double click one edge. It selects then all edges and we say horizontal, vertical. To very easy control the sketch, I will select even lines or similar lines, which should be all equal. So all these four edges that define the distance from the top corner to the inside and make this equal. I will also select the two vertical lines, make this equal. There we are. Perfect. There we are. This line I must have missed. There. And now when we adjust it, you see this beautifully is being controlled. 2 millimeters material thickness. Then the distance here, we select two lines, 2 millimeters too. And I need to have actually a line on top and the bottom to close these openings, because if I now exit the sketch and zoom out, you see here, instead of now selecting the H, I select the space inside the letter H. With those two profiles selected, I can now simply select one edge of my handle and call the sweep command. This piece should go. This will actually then allow me to select the end faces of this and the two swept bodies, and then I push them simply back. So this is now 15 millimeters and now from 15, 2 millimeters material thickness. If I would like this to be a little bit thicker, 18, 19. So now we have 4 millimeters material thickness there. Very good. Beautiful. Okay. Also here, the sketch can go. We don't need it anymore. And what we will do now is I will select these three bodies and then call the subtract command. This is all actually correctly selected. So my main body is the plus. That's actually the target. The other two are minus blue. These are the tools. If you click on these icons, you see that then they are actually changed in their function. We don't want to keep any originals. Click done. And there we have this chord out. Fantastic. So now we can actually go ahead and start finishing design. Now we're going to add all the fillets. I will start here with the inside. I will select all these inner edges and give this a 0.5 millimeter fillet, just a little bit. This is not something we're going to put our finger in or so. So this can be nice and round and small. The outside edges will be bigger. Here, if I drag this, I can now explore. 3 millimeters is the max, and this is actually then a nice rounding. Very good. So 3 millimeters we should keep in mind, because that's also what we're going to use for the edges that actually go in there. Then an outer edge, an inner edge, the second outer edge. Very good. And then we can drag this 1 millimeter. That looks good. So 1 millimeter. Perfect. Very nice. And then the inside edge here, and I select one inside edge at the bottom. Now here we have to be careful. This probably can also be 0.25. We have more space than 0.5 millimeter. Very good. Now you see here, this is bigger. Our hand or fingers will go over it. That's a bigger rounding. It's nice and soft. The inside, we don't really feel much. We don't want to have a sharp edge anyway there too. So a little bit of rounding is good. Then we can show now everything. Let's go to this part. Here we select these two outer edges. These were 3 millimeters, so we can do the same. 3, and then this turns this into a nice circular surface. Very nice. Perfect. Before we join actually this onto the bucket, we have to make copies. Mirror it over. So I select both bodies and then go to more and mirror. I can select the construction plane, or I can select this back face. This is the same. It's a very symmetrical design. There we are. And then the two handle parts I join together. Yeah. Boolean union command. Then now these two sockets I join onto the main bucket, union. Very good. And these outer edges are really important, again, for ergonomic purpose. So I will round those first, 1 millimeter. I have a little bit of space, okay, 2 millimeters. Very good. This tells me here now I don't have much space. So 0.25, 0.5 for millimeter. Very good. Here I would like to do the same. And instead of calling a second command, I will go in the design history to the feature that does that edge rounding. That's fillet 12 in my case. Open the dialog, click on edges, and then I select here another edge and click done. And now that fillet command is applied to those tangent edges. Perfect. I go to the right view, do a section cut. I would like to zoom in. We can see here this gets a little bit tight. So if we want to, we can add makeup material inch. One millimeter of a fillet. Very good. I also have here the upper fillet, and then the fillet for the connection, and then the inner fillet. To sort it, I can drag this one up. Now it's actually the outer, then the inner, and then we do the piece on top. This is up to you to decide how you would like to work. Very good. Here, this fillet is now ready to be shown as G2, and the same here. To do that, I can click on this face, and then you see all the commands we have. There's actually a lofted surface. So I can click on showing the details, and then I switch this to G2. See, it takes now a moment to calculate. And G2. Very good. And then when we select, that's the fillet we used. And here we switch this to G2. The G2 fillet will also make really nice, beautiful flows, transitions between the three individual surfaces, for example. Perfect. The design is done. We can actually now go ahead and create a nice product presentation. Let's switch to the visualization mode. First thing, I will go to environment, go to gradient mode, so I can see our rendering, click on the cog, and I'm going to rotate the light a little bit. Perfect. Done. Materials, the main bucket, we'll make this out of PVC material. Double click and then click white. So it's a nice white material. We can drag this onto the handle. You see by dragging it just onto the handle, it applies the material to all faces of that body. And then here, the color we will tint directly. Here is the hex number 1D4EFF and enter. Beautiful. So whenever you actually drag your mouse around, you will get also a hex code. So this way it's very easy to copy a color and share it. The white bucket doesn't really pop out too much. The easiest way is now to give the background color a little bit of a tint. So I go back to environment, go to gradient mode, and then here we type the same hex code, 1D4EFF, but this is way too saturated, so we lower the saturation a little bit. There, this works really good. Perfect. We can now click on capture the individual views we would like to show. And with this, we have finished actually modeling this really nicely designed ergonomic water bucket. I hope this exercise was informative and you enjoyed it. Have a great day.